Good afternoon, my dear boys and girls. Today, we have to start the play. We must read out the conversations. And today, we would start with the beginning. First, the characters. Here, there are three major characters very suitable for a one-act play. Stepan Stepanovich Chubukov, a landowner. Natalia Stepanovna, his daughter, 25 years old. And Ivan Vasilevich Lomov, a neighbor of Chubukov, a large and hearty but very suspicious landowner. So we have got three characters, my dear students. One is Chubukov, a landowner. He is about 70 years old. Natalia, his daughter, 25 years old. Lomov, another landowner. He is also 35 years old. Setting: Chubukov's country house. Chubukov's country house. And you need to learn more that it is the drawing room of Chubukov's country house. The drawing room of Chubukov's country house. So, the stage of the play can be looked upon as the country house, as the drawing room or sitting room of Chubukov's country house. Okay, now we must go through the dialogue. Chubukov is sitting in his drawing room. Lomov enters wearing a dress jacket and white gloves. Chubukov rises to meet him. So, students, you can easily understand. Lomov enters into the drawing room with wearing a dress jacket. Dress jacket means a short jacket extending up to the hip. Extending up to the hip and white gloves. Chubukov rises to meet him. Chubukov rises to accept him. Chubukov: "My dear fellow, whom do I see? Ivan, I am extremely glad." Squeezes his hand. "Now, this is a surprise, my darling. How are you?" Here you can see the sweet words run faster than sweet fluid. "My dear fellow, whom do I meet? Whom do I see? Ivan, I am extremely glad." He says that he is very much glad. He is very much happy to see Lomov at his house. And actually, Lomov has come so many days after. So, he was a little bit surprised. "My darling, how are you?" "Lomov, thank you. And how may you be going on?" Lomov thanked him and also asked him how he was. "Chubukov, we just get along somehow, my angel, to your prayers and so on. Sit down, please do. Now you know you shouldn't forget all about your neighbors. My darling, my dear fellow, why are you so formal in your getup? Why are you so formal in your getup? Evening dress, gloves and so on. Can you be going anywhere? My treasure, again I am telling you, the adjectives, the endearing words are flowing, are blowing like wind. Actually, these are all coming out from their tongues, but not from the depth of hearts. You will easily understand it as the play progresses. Anyway, Chubukov expressed that they were doing along well. And also reminded him that, praised him that as a neighbor, Lomov had not forgotten Chubukov. Lomov, no, I have come only to see you. Honored Stepanovich. So, Lomov, being asked why he had gone there, he simply told him that he only went there. Only to meet him, see him. Chubukov, then why are you in evening dress? That means evening dress means party dress. So again he repeated the query and emphasized the question why he was in evening dress. It was surprising. As if paying a New Year's Eve visit. New Year's Eve means 31st December. You know, among the Christian communities, there is a ritual that they celebrate the 31st December. And wait for the midnight to observe the new year or to celebrate the new year with much pomp and splendor. So they put on very rich clothes. Well, you see, it is like this. Actually, there is no answer with him right now. So he tells that he has come, take his arm. He takes the hand of Chubukov. I have come to you, honored Stepanovich, to trouble you with a request. Please underline, to trouble you with a request. Please underline. He said that his intention was clear right now, but it was not totally clear. He only told the old man that he went there to trouble him with a request. Not once or twice have I already, not once or twice, that means he went there or he came to this house more than twice, and the Chubukovs always greeted him and fulfilled his expectation. Okay, thank you. Let us move on. Chubukov, aside. Students, you need to know what aside means here. Actually, the speech which will be told by Chubukov just now, this speech would be meant for the audience, but not for the character standing by him or standing near him. Aside, He has come to borrow money. Shan't give him any. Chubukov now thinks that the actual intention of Lomov to him is to borrow money, and he is determined not to offer him or not to borrow him a single rupee or a single ruble. Allowed, that means now this is the speech which the speaker as well as the audience can hear. Understand what is aside and allowed means? What is it, my hearty? So what he thinks, he doesn't say. This is the peculiar characteristics of those people, those adult people, those septuagenarian people who think and who tell differently. Lomov, you see, Honor Stepanovich, I beg pardon, Stepan Stepanovich, I mean, I am awfully excited. This is the problem with Lomov, that he gets excited always and he cannot deliver the words for which actually he comes. As you will please notice, in short, you alone can help me, though I don't deserve it. Actually, Lomov has come, you know why he has come, but he cannot say why he has come, so he is going round and round. I don't deserve it, of course, and haven't any right to count on your assistance. Count on your assistance, get your assistance. Actually, count on means get. Assistance means help. So he is hesitant, not little bit, but more hesitant. Chubukov tells him, oh, don't go round and round it, darling, spit it out. Well, Chubukov simply told him not to go round and round, not to go round and round, but to spit it out. Underline the phrase, spit it out means tell me straightly what you want to tell. Okay, we will move further on. Lomov, 1 minute, the very minute. The fact is, I have come to ask the hand of your daughter, Natalia Stepanovna, in marriage. Now he cleared his intention and you have also known to the fact that the 35 years old Lomov, a bachelor till now, has come for a marriage proposal for Natalia, Chubukov's daughter. So now the reaction of Chubukov after hearing the proposal of Lomov. Students, you must be very attentive and very careful. Now joyfully, Chubukov is very joyful, he is very excited. Actually, he was expecting, by Jove, Ivan, say it again, I didn't hear it all. expression, wonderful expression. By Job, that means he swears by God Job. Even, and he so excited that he wants even to say the proposal once more. Lomov, I have the honor to ask, then some dot dot dot. He wants to tell more Lomov, but Chubukov is so excited, so emotionally overwhelmed that he wants to tell more, interrupting. My dear fellow, I am so glad, and so on. You indeed, and all that. Sort of thing. I have been hoping for it for a long time. It has been my continual desire. Shed tears. That means the old man has got emotional very much. So he was so emotionally overwhelmed that some real tears were coming out of his eyes. And I have always loved you, my angel. And if you were my own son, sorry, may God give you both his health. The man is so excited that he is telling all the soft words, his love and so on. That means he prayed to the Almighty that the Almighty should offer him help and others. And I did so much hope. What am I behaving in this idiotic way? Then he collects himself and tells why he is behaving in such a way. I am off my balance. Please underline this line. Please underline it. I am off my balance with joy. Absolutely. So he is overjoyed. He is so joyed that he feels himself imbalanced, and he is telling so much words and tears are coming out like the eruptions of volcano. Okay, boys, if you find any problem, please tell me. I will stop for a bit and then I want to have your reactions.